Hi guys, welcome to Absence Pro, welcome to another tutorial video. In this video, I'll teach you guys how you can set up an error workflow. So if you're creating N8N workflows, then it is really important for you to set up an error notification workflow. So if your one of active workflows is throwing an error, you will automatically get a notification like Slack notification or email notification. And it is really easy to set up, super simple to simple. So if you want to learn, make sure to watch the complete video and do not forget to subscribe the channel. So let's get into the screen. So that is the workflow, which is basically connected with the Slack. If you want to learn how to connect Slack with your N8N, I have created a tutorial. You will find multiple tutorials on my channel related to N8N. And N8N is a super awesome tool for creating AI agents, AI automations. You can basically connect any of the tool with the N8N and automate a lot of repetitive tasks. So all you have to do is just go to my channel and search for N8N and you will find all of the N8N related videos here. Alternatively, you can click on playlist and then click on view full playlist where you will find all of the N8N related video. Now let's get into this workflow. So if I click on execute workflow, it is going to throw me on error to my Slack where it says that example workflow because I haven't yet initiated a valid error. It's just basically giving us an example workflow. And if I double click on that, you can see all of the data. That was the execution ID. We will be getting that as well. And we have this message and we can basically set this one workflow for all of our active workflows. So if one of the workflow is not working, it is going to send us Slack notification, or you can also add in another node for Gmail where you can simply add in Gmail email notification or email notification to any of your email address. Now let's throw a live example. So this is another workflow, which is basically a chatbot, a RAG chatbot trained on my data. So if I click on open chat and say, hey, how are you? It is working fine, right? And make sure the workflow where you want to have an execution for this error workflow, it is activated. It is not going to throw an error on inactive workflows. Make sure it is active. I'm going to create this error deliberately by disconnecting this chat node from my AI agent. Click on save and also make sure that it is selected on your settings. So if you click on these three small dots and then click on settings, here you have the option of error workflow to notify when this one throws an error, right? So make sure you have the error workflow, which is in my case, workflow not working, is selected on this dropdown here. If it isn't selecting, it will not throw an execution. It will not run an execution. So make sure it is selected and you have this one deactivated or inactivated, not the active workflow, which will throw an error for all of the active workflows. And now if I click on chat and open this chat on a new tab and try to create an artificial error by sending a message, you can see that we have this error in workflow. And now when I go back, I got a new Slack notification where it says WSP chatbot copy workflow is not working, which is basically the name of my workflow here. So if I go back here, you can see that WSP chatbot copy is my workflow name. Now it is super simple to simple. I'm gonna create a new workflow in order to show you guys how you can set that up. So let's create a new workflow. And here, click on this plus sign and search for error. And it is basically going to trigger an error. And you don't need to activate this workflow. It has to be deactivated. You don't need to activate this workflow. Perfect. And if I click on fetch test event, you can see that it is giving us this test event, which is going to have all of this information like execution ID, retry, error, and all of that details. I'm simply going to connect it to my Slack, or you can connect it to your email as well. So let's select send a message. Now it is going to send me a message to user. I'm going to select my name to be the user And here in the message text, I'm simply going to first make sure to drag and drop the name so it is informing me the name dynamically, the same workflow which is not working. Meaning if this, for example, WSP chatbot copy is not working, it is going to have this name showing up here as opposed to example workflow. So we have added a dynamic variable, so it's not the static value, so we can create one error workflow for all of our active workflows. Is not working, please check what is the issue with the workflow, right? Now I'm adding all of the static text, and we can also add in the URL of that workflow which is not working. So you will basically get an email or a Slack message about the name of that workflow and the URL of that workflow which is not working dynamically. So that's how easy it is to set up error workflow in N8N. And it is really important to have it, because if you have multiple active workflows and one of workflow is creating any error, you will get notified at the same time whenever it throws an error. So if you are creating workflows for customers, for yourself, for automations, make sure to have that error workflow on your workflows, because it will save you a lot of time, and you won't be having surprise from your customers saying that automation is not working. You will be notified earlier and you will get an error via Slack or email instantly whenever you have error on your workflow. And that's it for the video, guys. It was a small video to show you guys how you can set up an error workflow. Until next video, have a great day.